Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, the presentation of colors and the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming,
and the rockets red glare,
the bombs bursting in air,
gave proof through the night
that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm Lon Moeller, Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs and Provost. It's my great privilege to welcome you to the Spring 2021 Virtual Graduate Commencement Ceremony for Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University's Daytona Beach campus. At this time, it's my honor to introduce our guest on stage this afternoon. Members of the platform party, as I call your name, please stand and remain standing. Dr. Karen Gaines, Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences. Dr. Alan Stolzer, Dean of the College of Aviation. Dr. Shannon Gibson, Dean of the David B. O'Malley College of Business. Dr. Maj Mimrani, Dean of the College of Engineering. Dr. Ahmed Abdelghani, Associate Dean for Research and Professor of Operations Management, and today's faculty speaker. Dr. P. Barry Butler, University President. Dr. Phil Elliott Jr., Esquire, Trustee Emeritus. And Dr. Chris Grant, Associate Provost of Academic Support and Mace Bearer. At this time, the Reverend David Keck will offer the invocation.
Good afternoon, and it is a good afternoon. You've worked incredibly hard in a very difficult time, and you've done it. You've earned your degrees, you're about to head forth and do some amazing things. We're incredibly proud of you. In the invocation, we give thanks for all those who made today possible. At the end of the invocation, I'll say, let all God's children say, invite you to respond, amen. Let's give thanks. Thank you, dear God. This is a day which you have made. We rejoice and are glad in it. We thank you for the students whose achievements we're celebrating today. We thank you for their hard work, dedication, perseverance. We thank you for their creativity and insight if they've taken a higher step in their education, become true masters of their field. We thank you for all the staff who've been working hard and preparing this place for a healthy, a safe place. We thank you for the cleaning staff and all the folks who've been creating new protocols so we can be here and our students can complete their education. We thank you for the staff, the administration, the faculty, all who've worked hard under difficult circumstances. We thank you for family, for friends, all those who provided encouragement, support, and love. Bless these graduates. Continue to give them strength, insight, and wisdom. See them through these days, they may become leaders in their fields. Continue to bless them as they have blessed us. And let all God's children say, amen.
Thank you, Reverend Keck. I want to take a opportunity at this moment to offer a special welcome to the parents, the friends, family members, spouses, significant others, and all the folks who supported, encouraged, and sacrificed in order to help our graduates achieve what it is we're recognizing here this afternoon. Graduates, you've completed your studies, and you're earning your degree from Embry-Riddle during a time complicated by the challenges associated with the COVID-19 pandemic. You've shown great resiliency that is remarkable, and resiliency that will help you stand out as you leave Embry-Riddle and start your professional careers. Special thanks this afternoon to our own ROTC Joint Color Guard for the presentation of colors, as well as our a cappellas for their presentation of our national anthem, and later, our alma mater. At this point, we wish to recognize several contributors who play key roles in the successful operation of this great university and of today's ceremony. The first group includes the Board of Trustees and the officers of the university. The second group includes those who prepared and mentored our Ph.D. and master's degree candidates for their future careers, and that would be our very own Embry-Riddle faculty. The next group, deserving special recognition, includes our dedicated staff. Without their hours of tireless work, the ceremony would not be possible. Now, I speak for the university when I say that we're all very proud of you and the work that you have done here at Embry-Riddle. We look forward to learning of your successes in the future, and we are very pleased to welcome you as colleagues to the Ph.D. and master's ranks of our academic community. Now to the business at hand. Dr. Elliott, will you please come forward and officially open our virtual graduate commencement ceremony?
On behalf of the Board of Trustees of Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University, it is my pleasure to declare the spring 2021 virtual commencement ceremony open. At this time, I am pleased to introduce President P. Barry Butler.
Congratulations, graduates. Aerospace and aviation need your talents more than ever. You will speed the recovery as we move past the pandemic and realize advances that will redefine travel and transportation on and off the planet. I say that with confidence based on what you have contributed to Embry-Riddle. Many of you came to your graduate studies with aviation and aerospace experience or following military service. The perspective you brought to classes and labs enriched everyone working alongside you. As scholars and researchers, you have helped us ensure that what we do here is relevant and focused. You brought fresh thinking that sharpened our research. You helped attract recognition to our university as a research center and an industry partner that delivers critical skills and solves challenging problems. You inspired and supported our faculty. The opportunity to work with talented graduate students allows us to recruit and retain talented professors and deans. The questions you asked and the answers you discovered keep our faculty excited about our work. That enthusiasm reaches our undergraduates as well. As graduates of demanding programs, you raise the level of professionalism for the entire industry. I'm confident that through your contributions, you will continue to distinguish yourselves. Whether your future takes you to the classroom, the lab, the boardroom, or a colony on Mars, we are proud to call you Eagles. Congratulations. Thank you. We can't wait to see what you'll do next.
Thank you, President Butler. At this time, I would like to introduce Dr. Ahmed Abulghani, Associate Dean for Research and Professor of Operations Management. I welcome Dr. Abulghani to the podium to deliver this afternoon's address.
Good afternoon, good evening, good morning to you all. Depending on when you are watching this live event or its recording. Dear audience, it's my pleasure to be with you today in the spring 2021 virtual graduate commencement ceremony. While I was hoping to be with you in person, I'm grateful that we are still able to celebrate this important event together virtually. Let me first start my speech by thanking the university administration for inviting me to be the guest speaker for this ceremony. It's truly my honor and always my pleasure. Dear graduates of the Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University Master's and Doctorate Class of 2021, congratulations. You have made it and you have made us proud. Today is a day of celebration. I would like to recognize everyone in the audience who has provided unconditional love and support to these graduates, including family, friends, the university administration, the board of trustees, our distinguished faculty and staff. Graduates, I can accurately assume that when all of you submitted your application to enroll for graduate degree, none of you could have imagined that the last 15 months of your study would be like this as a result of the coronavirus pandemic. Graduate study by itself is demanding. This abnormal situation definitely added many dimensions to the challenge. If I recall one aspect from my graduate study more than 20 years ago, I say it required a continuously focused, undistracted mind. Unfortunately, this pandemic has made us all distracted and in different ways. It put us in a constant state of worry. Worry about the health and well-being of our loved ones, sometimes worry about finances, worry about securing a job after graduation in an undefined market, and more drastically, worry about how to deal with a new constrained environment that is imposed suddenly on all of us almost overnight. Regardless of all of this unprecedented challenges, you graduates were up to it and you dominated. Congratulations. I hope that we will soon be able to put this episode behind us and look to a prosperous future. I'm congratulating you today on achieving the important milestone in your life of completing your degree successfully. Yet, I'm congratulating you on something else as well. I'm commending you on successfully passing one crucial quiz you faced in life. No, I'm not talking about that Bob quiz that you got in your statistics class. In fact, you probably didn't even recognize the experience as a quiz. Before I explain to you what the quiz was about, I want to let you know that you proved to us that you are on the right track by even exposing yourself to its content. Passing this quiz has definitely increased our confidence in you that you will continue to succeed throughout your future. By the way, I can assure you that this quiz won't be your last. Thus, I hope that when you encounter it again in future, you pass it successfully, exactly as you did with this last one. Now I guess you have been wondering what quiz I'm talking about. Let me take you back in time when you were fresh-faced, young, impressionable undergraduates. It is here where you encountered your first question. Do I need more education? Apparently, you answered yes. And this answer is the true reason for our celebration today. Psychology literature states that most human beings tend to overestimate what they really know. Cornell University social psychologist David Dunning asserts, quote, "People overestimate themselves, but more than that, they really seem to believe it," unquote. I can guarantee that most of you are blessed by an internal truthful command, which guided you in the right direction to answer this question. You did not do like most people that psychologists are referring to. You did not overestimate yourself. You sincerely evaluated yourself and candidly decided you needed to build on your knowledge and skills. You also likely evaluated the implications of not pursuing more education and what it would mean to invest time and effort into your education. You probably considered other options, like starting a job or taking a time off. And so, with all of these considerations, you marked yes. Congratulations. My advice to you is to take the best care of this gift you have, the internal truthful command. You will need it more than what you imagine. The world around us is changing faster than ever. Every day, many innovations are coming our way. Keep this command active and keep it alert. You can think of it as a security system that you have in your house. The system must always be active to give you and your family the most protection. You might be surprised if I tell you the best way to keep this command active, alert, and charged is to continue learning. Dear graduates, treat learning as a habit. By prioritizing your education every day, you are charging the battery of this internal truthful command to be ready to guide you in the right direction in the future. Remember, we are all learning now. So we are learning now so we are able to continue to learn in the future. We need more education today to correctly select what we must learn tomorrow. The last two decades have witnessed considerable change to the diversification, accessibility, and the content of learning platforms. At any time and at anywhere, we are a few mouse clicks away from what we need to learn about. We almost have no excuse. Nonetheless, do not also ignore many other learning experiences around you. Listen to people, ask questions, and questions answers, and pay attention to causes, not to the effect. If you pay attention, every person is a teacher and everything is a lesson. So, in the future, when you are faced with the short quiz of whether to pursue education, I hope your command is alert and guides you to answer yes. When you are given the opportunity to learn, take it. And also, before I forget, when you are given the opportunity to help others to learn, be generous. Congratulations, graduates of the 2021 class. I wish you the best. Keep us proud and go Eagles. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Albagani. That was very inspiring and thoughtful advice for our graduates today. When our graduate degree candidates are shown on the screen, you'll notice that a number of them are acknowledged with distinction. They've achieved a grade point average of 4.0 and are presented with a gold medallion. And now, we proceed to what we've all been waiting for, the awarding of the Ph.D. and master's degrees.
I have the distinct pleasure of introducing our Ph.D. candidates from the Colleges of Aviation and Engineering. Your exploration and innovation give us a sneak peek into the future of cleaner, smarter design, the science of flight, and all the critical issues that will carry us into the next golden age of aviation. In meeting the rigorous demands of developing and defending your dissertations, you have distinguished yourselves. Your work has also challenged our faculty to embrace new ideas and sharpen their skills. So I know you will each move the industry just as you have already benefited future Eagles. Congratulations.
Marissa D. Aguiar. David A. Carroll. Woojin Choi. Kabir Okasim. David 30acre. Stephen Peter Cronin. Sutong Niu. Isabel Mary McBrayer.
The Embry-Riddle faculty is now pleased to present the candidates for master's degrees from the College of Arts and Sciences, College of Aviation, the David B. O'Malley College of Business, and the College of Engineering. This time I invite Dr. Karen Gaines, Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, to come forward.
President Butler and Provost Mueller, it is my honor to present the candidates for master's degrees as recommended by the faculty from the College of Arts and Sciences.
James Allen Blake. Michelle Laura Nato, with distinction. Joshua Allen Jeremy. Elizabeth Allen, with distinction. Rachel L. Bauer, with distinction. Sadie Victoria Lynn Cook, with distinction. Kyle Lewis Gatrost. Emma Grimes, with distinction. Jamie Harmon. Jessica T. James, with distinction. Matthew Kukufka. Paige Lawton. Micah E. Martin. Adam Massoud. Dirk R. Mercer. Leah Smart Miller, with distinction. Abrielle Marie Otero, with distinction. Emily Kate Marcel, with distinction. Shivani J. Patel, with distinction. Diana Pereira. Christina Ariel Roy, with distinction. James Robert Sacca.
This concludes the presentation of master's degrees from the College of Arts and Sciences.
President Butler and Provost Mueller, it is my honor to present the candidates for master's degrees as recommended by the faculty of the College of Aviation.
Mohammed Tarek Mohammed Abdelmajid. Nazia Afrin. Sojung An, with distinction. William Joseph Bruno. Paul M. Cairns, with distinction. Ellie Hee-Jung Choi. Kevin Fernando. Hei-Hung Gao. Maluk Karbuch, with distinction. Kevin M. Convit, with distinction. Sang-A Lee, with distinction. John Binfield Ludlow. Tucker Ganton Mee. Shreya Manoj Mithal, with distinction. Andrew Seward. Enrique Alejandro Sosa Rodriguez. Leeson E. Thompson. Xiahao Yu. Xihao Shan, with distinction. Amanda Rose Darji. Mackenzie Tyler Dixon, with distinction. Arash M. Shikari.
This concludes the presentation of master's degrees from the College of Aviation.
President Butler and Provost Mueller, it is my honor to present the candidates for the master's degrees as recommended by the faculty of the David B. O'Malley College of Business.
Anna Jane Battison. Jovan Carrington Bruce. Connor George Gwynn, with distinction. Valentin Stanimirov-Ganchev, Sven Meisner, Maxwell Mikulski, Maria Judith Tindra Schmidhofer, with distinction, Douglas Mark Sibilia, Alex Suchenko, Stefanos Duki Mueller, Jacques-Philippe Boudreau, Michael Jean Fauché, Andres Franco Cardozo, Rodrigo Henrique Perry Ballarini, Ilya Priatopo, John Robert Brooks, Iran Wah, Yu Shin, Hirosha.
This concludes the presentation of the master's degrees from the David B. O'Malley College of Business.
President Butler and Provost Mueller, it is my honor to present the candidates for master's degrees as recommended by the faculty of the College of Engineering.
Swapnil Acharya, Jovan Carrington Bruce, Neva Nikhil Dave, Christopher Joseph Forte, Zachary W. Henry, with distinction, Mohammed Faisal Hossein, Gaurav Rajesh Joshi, Wanjiko Chibet Kanjumba, with distinction, Jaitra Manik Khanna, Harshal Anil Kumar Kohli, with distinction, Jackson Knight Lingen, Kristen Holly Metcalf, Jeffrey Douglas Malloy, Ken Shishino, Pedro Enrique Zilhi, Jonathan Sipple, with distinction, Yuvaniti Thirumaran, David William Thompson, with distinction, Bradford Ward, Matthew Michael Whittle, John K. Zelina, with distinction, Nicholas Shuzhu, Julian Gesso, with distinction, Fanny Margareta Christensen, with distinction, Erica Jade Schellenberger, with distinction, Mohammed Al-Buhairi, Mesa Mohammed Al-Ghamdi, Nora Jaralai Al-Elwit, Hashim Hassan Al-Nayami, Jamil Al-Sulami, Alisa Jaffrey, Mohammed Yusuf Al-Obeidi, Alexander Christian Bassett, with distinction, Mohammed El-Effendi, with distinction, Gay Fogg, with distinction, Donald Garbarino, Fang Yu He, with distinction, Alora Mary Mazarakis, with distinction, Xi Zhao Ni, long way to. How you yan? Yipang yan, with distinction. Wang Da Zhou, with distinction. Matthew Anthony Bullock. David Augustus Sikote, with distinction. Eng Du, with distinction. Tyler James Farnese. Andrew James Ferry. Jeff Garrod. James Hendrickson. Luke Christopher Keefe, with distinction. Daniel Patrick Lane. Jake Anthony Machado. Cody Philip Miller. Jonathan Gary Nato. Nicholas Charles Powell. Ankit Brukeyer. Jessica Vivian Savage. Alex Thomas Schiffer, with distinction. Colin Raymond Topolsky. Parker Kenneth Tyson, with distinction. Panikandan Veramani. Juan Sebastian Venegas Ariaza. Tyler Adam Wall. Fatima Mohammed Al Ghamdi. Juan Ortiz Cowder, with distinction. Shubham Sanjay Nipanagar. Nilesh Balkrishna Sawant.
This concludes the presentation of master's degrees from the College of Engineering. This also concludes the presentation of graduate degrees.
Graduates, on behalf of the university, allow me to be the first to congratulate each and every one of you on your outstanding accomplishments. You've achieved what very few people in the world have or will ever be able to do. However, with this achievement comes the responsibility of representing your profession and Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University the very best way that you can. If your efforts and your performance while students with us here at Embry-Riddle are any indication, I'm very confident that we will become even more proud of you than we are right now. And I truly believe that you are destined to leave your mark on your professions. Again, I congratulate each of you. Now this is the moment we've all been waiting for. Dr. Elliott, will you please join me at the podium? Graduates watching at home, please stand.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer on you, as appropriate, the Ph.D. degrees, the Master of Business Administration, and the Master of Science degrees, with all of the rights, privileges, honors, and responsibilities appertaining thereunto. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Elliott. And again, our congratulations, graduates. To conclude today's ceremony, please join us in singing our alma mater, performed by the a cappellas, followed by the benediction.
Eagles gather near, we lift our voices loud and clear, soaring high, O alma mater, threads of blue and gold, united. United we soar in vast open skies. Embry-Riddle, we hail thee, great memories we'll hold. So here's to you, old ERAU, alma mater true. We pledge in love and harmony our loyalty to you. Singing thy praise, remembering the days, coast to coast around the world, our bonds forever true. Embracing our dreams with pride far and wide, Embry-Riddle, we hail thee, great memories we'll hold. So here's to you, old ERAU, alma mater true. We pledge in love and harmony our loyalty to you.
A benediction is a blessing, a final blessing. And following your speaker today, your blessing today will be a quiz. True or false? I need more blessing. The answer is true. You continue to need the blessings you've received from family, friends, colleagues, faculty, so many people who made this day possible. True or false? I will bless others. You've been given power. Knowledge is power. You know, things that a small percentage of people in the world know, apply them well, wisely, faithfully. Bless the world with your knowledge. Question number three, do you need more education? At this point, you should know the answer to that question is yes. Now, for those of you who are looking for extra credit on this quiz because you're not sure how you did or because your faculty member still hasn't posted grades on Canvas, please know that to get extra credit, stay in touch. We're gonna miss you. You're a fantastic group of men and women. Done wonderful things. As President Butler said, we depend on you. You've made our lives different. We're gonna miss you. So stay in touch. Let all God's children say, amen. This concludes today's ceremony. It's the beginning of your flight. Go forth. Thank you.